Hi everyone, welcome back. So in this video we are going to learn about iron atoms, and in the later videos we'll see how to put this iron atom inside an iron list to display the data coming from an API in a list form. So let's get started. Let's open our application in Visual Studio Code. Now our application resides inside the source and app folder, and we are working on home page, and that we will see here in homepage.html. This is the iron header, and okay, let's do one thing, open the terminal and see how our app looks. To open the terminal, we can go to view and click on terminal, or we can use the shortcut command control plus backtick. So here is our integrated terminal, and to execute our application in the browser, let me give the proper command ionic serve. Till the time our application is opening up, let's start the browser and search for the ionic official documentation. And we are going to learn about, we know want to go to I. See, our application is opening up, and let me press Ctrl Shift and M to see the mobile layout. And in the ionic documentation, let's go to UI components and search for iron item. Here is our iron items, and so there is a lot of things that we can customize. So I think this iron item will go for a couple of videos. Stay tuned for all the properties that we can set. Let me minimize this window so that we can see the changes instantly that we do. Let me minimize the terminal and the Project Explorer as well, because we are not going to work on any other file, only on the home page. Our two things are already complete, the toolbar and the side menu, and now we are going to learn about iron atoms. So let me do something. Let me put three labels here first. Label one. So see, I just put three iron labels inside the iron content, and iron content is actually the screen from this end to this end. Now I have not used iron item here. Why? Because I want to show you something. Is if I am putting only three labels, there is no margin and padding given to these labels. But see what happens when I wrap them inside an iron item UI component. Save and refresh and see. When the iron labels are wrapped inside an iron item UI component, some default padding and margin and behavior is given to these labels. If we just a quick revision, let me comment this and save it, and you can see the difference. So we have not used any attribute inside iron item, but still it gives some padding and margin by default. So this is the one of the things that I wanted to show you, and let's go to all the theory one by one. Items are elements that contain text, icons, avatars, images, inputs, and a lot of things. Okay, so guys, iron item is used to wrap inside it a lot of things, such as images, text, form, inputs, labels, texts, and other media as well. We can group a lot of things inside an iron item. Let's go to the next item. Okay, an item is considered clickable if it has an href or button property. Okay, तो अभी अपन को ये देखना है कि क्या अपना जो item है clickable है, तो अगर मैं माउस पॉइंटर को यहाँ ले जाऊँ और इट्स नॉट क्लिकेबल, मैं आई वॉन्ट टू क्लिक इट बट आई एम नॉट एबल टू क्लिक इट. सो इफ आई वॉन्ट टू मेक इट क्लिकेबल इट शुड हैव एन एच रेफ और अ बटन प्रॉपर्टी सेट. जस्ट ट्राई इट आउट एच आर एफ एंड सेव इट. एंड ओके नाउ व्हेन आई एम होवरिंग माई माउस my mouse pointer is changing into a hand and it means it is now clickable. What if I click it? Okay, there is some link that is being redirected to, and we are actually coming back to the same link. So we can achieve this with the help of a button as well. I have removed the HRF and again it's normal, and see what happens when I give a button attribute. So when I give a button attribute, it again makes the item clickable. When I click here, this okay, see there is a ripple effect. We can notice a ripple effect when we click the item. So href and button give a similar type of experience to me, but there must be something different in both of them, because then there will be no difference in both of them. So just I wanted to take a bit on the code samples given here, and if you can see here, the href attribute is an anchor. I mean, it redirects, or some URL is involved when href, or I can say href is involved when there is some URL. If we want to navigate to some other page inside the application, or to some website, or to some other resource that could be located with the help of a URL, we use the href attribute. And if we want to perform some action, then we use the button property. So let me demonstrate the button property. So button is given, and let me use click event. And if you can see here, button click, it's a function. So we need to make that function as well, and this the name of this function could be anything, it's up to us. So I am giving it do something, and wrongly I placed it outside the double quotes, and now I have to define it do something. And where I have to define it? We will have to define it inside a ts file, homepage.ts. So I have already defined it here. So you can see, if we want a function to be triggered on clicking an item, we need to give the attribute button and define and give the name of function that will be triggered on its click. So let's do it. Let's just go on with the thing. Let me maximize this window and inspect the element, go to the console, delete the content, control shift M, and let's click here. Okay, as we are clicking, see the button is clicked. The as we clicked the iron item, the event is triggered, the click event is triggered, and do something function is called. The do something function is defined inside homepage.ts file, and whatever we want to do on a button click, we can write our logic there. So this is the difference between href and the button. So let's move forward, where there are a lot of things to study, see. So we now know what is the difference between an href and a button. Detail arrows. By default, clickable items will display a right arrow icon on iOS mode. But I have not seen any right arrow till now. We have made a button, we have called a function, and there is no icon. So how is that possible? Let's see. By default, clickable item will display right arrow icon on iOS mode. Okay, if the mode is iOS, then it will be shown. So let me give a mode of iOS here. me save it. Okay, as the mode I was given, we can see an arrow displayed. What if my mode is not iOS, and even then if I want the arrow, then set the detail property to false and detail property to true. Okay, so let me just remove the mode iOS and give the detail property a value of true. I have made the changes and the app is separate, and see, I can even now see the detail arrow. Okay, let's go to the next thing. Okay, before going to item placement, there is one more thing I would like to show you, that is in conjunction with this detail arrow functionality. Let's go down in the documents. So here it is, detail icon. So detail icon sets the icon that the user can see. I mean, this icon is actually given by the detail icon attribute, and by default it is chevron forward. So let me use it here as well. Chevron forward. So by default it's chevron forward. So if there is a forward, okay, can I use another icon here? If I use add, okay, so we can see that we can put an icon of our choice on the an item if it's clickable. We can put add, we can put anything else. I think can we put the search? Okay, search is also visible. And what about the cart? And cart is also visible. Okay, so and now it is a straightforward property, I think. And now I would like to give a piece of advice here, guys. These applications are used by a lot of people in the world, and the icons must be put in such a manner that it clearly propagates the real meaning of that icon. I mean, if there is a plus, then it must मतलब it must मतलब उससे सामने वाले को ये कुछ ऐसा एहसास देना चाहिए कि यार इस प्लस पे क्लिक करोगे तो समथिंग विल एड अप. सो यहाँ पर हम क्या चाह रहे हैं कि व्हेनेवर समबडी क्लिक्स हियर, he will be taken to another page, matlab he will be moved forward. That's why we are giving a by default icon of forward. So these icons must be, the choice of these icons must be semantically right. I mean, they should propagate the right meaning to the user. So we have learned some things here, and with this I conclude this video, and stay tuned for more properties in the next video. Thanks.